While searching for a cure to the pirate-afflicting parks of LeChuck, the fates of Guybrush Threepwood and Morgan Le Fay are blown off course when they are swallowed by a lovelorn leviathan. Much to Morgan and Guybrush's surprise, an uneasy alliance to escape the beast blossoms into a genuine friendship between the pirate and pirate hunter. A tidal shift that leads Threepwood to the elusive Pox curing Esponja Grande. But Guybrush learns too late that it is the wise pirate who prepares for the inevitable change in the winds as Morgan betrays him and returns him to the scientific clutches of the Marquis de Sange.
$30,000 pieces of silver, mon petit chouchou. Just as we agreed.
It had better be, or I'll cut the difference out of your fluffy wig.
I got an idea. Why don't you let me go and I'll pay you double what the Marquis is paying.
Don't embarrass yourself, Threepwood.
Oh yeah? I'll pay triple.
Ha!
Quadruple?
Ha!
Quintuple? Sextuple?
Threepwood, you grossly underestimate the value of that which gushes through your body.
Well, I've got a pretty good idea. Why, my spit alone once won me 8,000 pieces of eight on Booty Island.
Then you should die knowing that you gave a priceless gift to science! Finally! I've got the Threepwood! I've got the formula! And soon I'll have nothing left than life eternal! Oh, I'm as happy as a penguin sliding on its belly! What is this?
Ah, it's a welcome back party! Hope they brought ice cream cake.
Guybrush Threepwood! We've been waiting a long time for this.
Hey, why can't I stop my legs?
What? No! No, come back! This cracker croaker's got a date in the court of pirate law, you test tube tinkering Talleyrand!
What? And then the scurvy dog will hang.
You! After him!
Hey, I brought you Threepwood, and you paid me. We're done here.
We'll just see about that.
You'll be taken to the nearest ship and keel hard until your ravaged skin hangs in tatters from your bleep.
Guilty? But I haven't been charged with anything yet.
You haven't? Where's that incompetent prosecutor?
Right here, Your Honor.
Oh, great.
Sorry I'm late, Your Eminence, but old Stan had to in flagrante his delicto. And there was a line in the washroom.
Belay your excuses, you sniveling sea weasel, and get on with the charges! I've got grog waiting for me at Club 41!
Of course, Your Immensity. Your Honor, pirates and wenches of the gallery.
Hey, that's us.
This evening I will prove beyond a scintilla of a shadow of a doubt that Guybrush Threepwood is guilty of no fewer than four heinous crimes.
I thought there'd be three.
Firstly, that he did knowingly engage in a bar fight that horribly injured the beloved feline of local pirate elder, Hemlock McGee.
Hey, it's too good for him!
Secondly, during this self-same fight, Captain Threepwood spilled boiling nacho sauce on the exposed leg of Bosun Catherine Krebs, hideously scarring one of Flotsam's shapeliest gams.
Hit him alive!
Thirdly, that he did conspire with one Joaquin de Oro to craft and sell counterfeit porcelain power pirates.
All about spreading the box!
And finally, that he folded, spindled, and mutilated this previously pristine ex belonging to Flotsam's newest arrival, Killick Hardtack.
What the heck?
Yeah, he did that to me.
Captain Threepwood, having heard the grave charges arrayed against you, how do you plead?
I plead 1,000% not guilty, especially that last one about the X.
Very well. Let it be recorded that the miserably guilty defendant has entered a plea of not guilty. Now, who would you like to represent your pathetic case?
I guess I'll represent myself.
Captain Threepwood, are you aware of the old pirate court saying? The pirate who represents himself in court has a soon-to-be keel-hauled fool for a client.
Yes, Your Honor, and I am that fool.
Fine! Your move, Counselor!
Here's your briefs, kid.
If it pleases the court, I'd like to call Bailiff Hardtack to the stand.
Bailiff Hardtack!
Oh, that's me.
Do you swear on Blackbeard's log to tell the truth to the best of your ability as a grog-swilling, backstabbing pirate? I suppose.
Bailiff Hardtack, could you tell the court about your claim against Guybrush Threepwood?
Well, back on Spinner K, I was getting ready to bury me modest chest of treasures, you see. My collection of spaghetti strainers, my silver paprika shaker, and so on. When all of a sudden, this Threepwood bloke runs up to me, waving his arms and telling me to look out for a three-headed monkey that's right behind me. Well, naturally, I turned and looked, but there was nothing there. When I regained my composure, Threepwood was nowhere to be found. And worst of all...
Yes?
He dug up my perfectly good ex. It's ruined now.
Oh, come on. He's all yours, buddy.
This whole story about your ex is a big fat lie, isn't it?
No, sir.
Come on, you're lying. Admit it.
No, sir.
Come on.
Oh, you got me, sir.
But why?
Well, I didn't have anything else to do after you killed me boss and left me without a job.
Oh, I could have charged you with that instead. Oh.
Your Honor, I move for a mistrial.
Granted! Bailiff Hardtack! As punishment for wasting this court's time, you will be compelled to wear Lizig's wig of foppery until such time as I am no longer tempted to gavel you into a fine paste!
Ooh, it's delightful!
I'd like to call Bosun Catherine Krebs to the stand.
Catherine Krebs! Do you swear on Blackbeard's log to tell the truth to the best of your ability as a grog-swilling, backstabbing pirate?
Aye.
Bolson Krebs, could you tell the court what happened on that fateful day?
Aye. I was minding my own business at Club 41 with a mug full of grog and some zesty nachos when all of a sudden that blindfolded Jasper barreled into me, knocked me nacho sauce into me lap, and gave me this disfiguring scar.
Machi machi!
Aye, that takes me back.
Bailiff! Supply the prosecutor and the defendant with sketches of the burns for their briefs!
Aye, aye, Your Honor!
Lots of luck, kid.
Your Honor, I'd like to call a recess to confer with my client.
Bailiff! Please escort Captain Threepwood to the brig!
Aye, aye, Your Honor!
Well, at least I'm not about to be dissected by a crazy scientist. Now to break out of here, find Elaine and use La Esponja Grande to... Hey, what happened to my cool voodoo sponge?
All possessions will be returned to the prisoner once he has been cleared of all charges. In the likely event that the prisoner is not cleared of all charges, his property will be distributed to his heirs.
But I don't have any heirs that I know of.
Then they'll be auctioned off at eBay.
Hey, guard!
What do you want?
I want to see my lawyer.
Your lawyer?
Yeah, you might have heard of him. Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate at law.
Fine.
All right, counselor. Judge Grindstump says you got 5 minutes.
That should be more than enough for this piece of scum. I hope you had a good excuse for dragging me out of bed at this ungodly hour. I've got a plan to break out of this joint, but I need your help to smuggle in a wombat and 2 sticks of string cheese. You want me, an officer of the court, to aid in a jailbreak? Why, the mere idea is so preposterous that it's practically postposterous.
Why, you...
Guard! I'm quite done with my client!
I'll get you, Threepwood, if it's the last thing I do!
Sorry about that, Mr. Threepwood. I know those prisoners can be a rowdy lot.
Think nothing of it, Mr. Hardtack. Now, where can I find a good grog?
Club 41's right over there, sir.
I wonder if Club 41's changed its restrictive policies. Ah, Club 41. Nothing screams pirate bar like the aroma of moldy grog sprinkled with just a hint of sea spray and shattered dreams.
I will double your quadruple rate.
Keep your gold, Silk Pants. You can't afford me anymore.
But you must break Threepwood out of jail and bring him back to me! He is the only one who has the poxalicious strains that I need.
You're a little behind the times, Demange. I'm pox-free and fit as a fiddle. See?
Impossible.
Nothing's impossible when Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate, is involved. And after I cure my wife and everyone else...
Wife?
Yeah. She was standing right next to me when LeChuck exploded, so the pox hit her pretty hard.
I want you to hunt down and capture this wife of Guybrush Threepwood.
Hey!
What part of Non do you not comprende?
But I need her! She's the only other pirate who could possibly have the Threepwood strain of the pox!
Then get her yourself.
My dear Mademoiselle Leflay, I don't get people. I hire people like you to get them for me. And if you won't get them, then maybe I'll find someone to get you.
I don't like to be threatened.
Oh! Oh, my phalange!
What the?
Oh! That was a very, very bad mistake, mademoiselle.
Well, it wouldn't be the first!
Jerk. Set me up with a line of Blood Island volcano shots.
Me pleasure. These come with our complimentary Club 41 insulated volcano shot glasses. Hewn out of molten lava. They can keep hot liquids hot for a week.
Impressive. Ooh, that's some hot grog-on-grog action. I'll just save this last one for later. Nothing like a little hot wax on a cold, flotsam night. Better get some of this before it cools. Warm.
Whoops!
Hey! Arr! Now look what you did! Arr! You clumsy clam clipper! You ruined my prototype! Now I'll have to start all over! Arr!
So if it's messed up, can I have it?
Fine, take it! Just get out of me sight! Arr!
This ought to help me get a leg up in the trial. See if this will work. Aha! Come on, let's get you out of here. Ooh. Sizzly. You know, if I was a little more scientifically inclined, I might be worried about the effects this stuff is having on any future generations of Threepwoods.
There.
It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate at law.
Oh, Counselor Threepwood! What can I do for you?
I'd like to return to court to defend my client.
Alrighty then, let's find Judge Grindstump.
The Pirate Court of Flotsam Island is back in session. The Right Honorable Wallace P. Grindstump presiding.
Let's keep it moving, Captain Threepwood!
I'd like to recall Bosun Krebs to the stand.
Catherine Krebs!
Now remember, darling, you're still under oath.
Aye.
Your Honor, I'd like to introduce this leg lamp into evidence as proof that Bosun Catherine Krebs is lying about her so-called nacho sauce burn.
This proves nothing!
Objection, Your Honor. The scars on this leg-shaped lamp may look like my client's, but who knows how they got there?
I'm glad you asked. So you see, Your Honor, Catherine's distinctive burns were not caused by Club 41's nacho sauce, but by an unlikely combination of scalding fluids found throughout Flotsam Island. Isn't that true, Bosun Krebs?
Answer the question! Yes, she-devil!
It's true. After Guybrush knocked that platter of nachos onto my lap, I saw my chance for revenge and concocted this foolish scheme.
Revenge?
You still don't remember me? The woman whose ship you sunk? Who spent years languishing in prison for your crimes? The woman whose husband you humiliated in that creepy karaoke contest?
Nope. Sorry. Drawing a blank.
Arr!
Your Honor, I move that Bosun Catherine Krebs's charge be dropped.
Counselor?
I got nothing, Your Honor.
Very well. In the matter of Krebs versus Threepwood, the Pirate Court of Flotsam Island finds in favor of the defendant Guy Brush Threepwood. Get off, you lot!
I'd like to call Joaquin Jacinto de Meara Alfonso de Oro to the stand.
Joaquin de Oro! Do you swear on Blackbeard's log to tell the truth to the best of your ability as a grog-swilling, backstabbing pirate? See?
Señor de Oro.
Capitán de Oro.
Yes, of course. Why are you here today?
I was recently arrested for trying to sell a counterfeit Dark Ninja Dave porcelain power pirate figurine. A counterfeit figurine. Crafted by Guybrush Threepwood.
Actually, that wasn't so surprising.
Your witness, Counselor.
Your Honor, I'd like to call a recess to confer with my client.
Bailiff! Please escort Captain Threepwood to the brig!
Aye, aye, Your Honor!
Hey, guard!
What do you want?
I want to see my lawyer.
Again?
Not getting any smarter. Lou?
You!
Doro? What happened to your eye?
I tell you what happened to my eye, smarty guy. When I dug up that phony Dark Ninja Dave you planted...
Allegedly planted?
Allegedly planted. I got a speck of dirt lodged in my eye. A week later, it got infected, and Dr. Desange had to cut it out.
Yeah, I just bet he did.
Now I need a glass eye.
Associating with hardened criminals like you can't be good for my legal situation. I'm out of here.
Adios.
Hello there, uninformed man on the street.
What do you want?
I see you can make a glass leg, but tell me, can you make a glass eye?
Aye. But not just any glass eyes. Genuine imitation eyes made from the crystal wreaths themselves.
Genuine imitation eyes?
That's right. They'll imitate the eye color of anyone they see. You just point them at someone's eyes, give him a few seconds to set, and shazam! All new eye color. When you got a color you like, just pop it in your eye socket, and it'll stay that way forever.
I'm intrigued and cautiously optimistic. How much?
Here, try out this defective one for free.
Defective?
Aye. It's a little nearsighted, so you'll have to get up real close to the subject to capture their eye color.
Thanks. I take back all the nasty things I wrote in my diary about you. I'll see you in your, pectorals later.
Yeah, well, the three of us will be waiting.
Who go? Oh, it's you.
I'd like to return to court to defend my client.
Alrighty then, let's find Judge Grindstump.
The Pirate Court of Flotsam Island is...
Yes, yes, get on with it!
Your Honor, I'd like to call Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate, to the stand.
Guybrush Threepwood!
I'm right here.
Oh, right. Do you swear on Blackbeard's log to tell the truth to the best of your ability as a grog-swilling, backstabbing pirate?
Ooh, what's this log made of? Calf leather? It just can't find craftsmanship like this these days.
Oh,
I do. Captain Sheepgood. Threepwood. Ah yes, Shreveport. Threepwood. Greensleeves. Threepwood. Treebeard? Threep... Slee... Wood... Stack.
Objection! Defense is stalling!
Get on with it! Or the court will order his name legally changed to Captain Guts for Garters!
Rawr!
crazy pose.
Gotcha!
Right! Where were we?
Your Honor, I'd like to call a recess to confer with my client.
Bailiff! Please escort Captain Threepwood to the brig!
Aye, aye, Your Honor!
Hey, guard!
What do you want?
I want to see my lawyer.
Again?
Not getting any smarter. Captain Doro?
Do you have it?
One nigh indestructible glass eye. Pox colored, just like all the cool pirates are wearing.
Hachi Santa Pica and Santa Fe! Ay, 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 ay. My eye is really scary.
Now, according to Crimp Digit, all you have to do to set it is pop it in your eye socket. Ooh.
How do I look?
Dangerous.
I think you mean dangerously cool, eh?
Sure, whatever. Now, about your testimony.
No problem, mi amigo. Just call me back to the stand and ask me about this.
Your Dark Ninja Dave Porcelain Power Pirates treasure map? I'd just smuggle this into here.
In my, let's say, mouth.
Who got... Oh, it's you.
I'd like to return to court to defend my client.
Alrighty then, let's find Judge Grindstump.
The Pirate Court of Flotsam Island is...
Yes, yes, get on with it!
I'd like to recall Captain Doro to the stand.
Can someone pull Doro out of his cell?
The court would like to remind Captain Doro that he is still under oath.
See?
Captain Doro, what can you tell me about this map?
Objection!
Defense Exhibit 42, Your Honor. This is the map the witness used to find his Dark Ninja Dave Power Pirate.
I'll allow it!
But...
Shut your eternally flapping mouth, you festering chum hole!
Continue.
I purchased this map at eBay 6 months ago from a traveling salesman with a plaid jacket and waving arms. He said that it was an authentic Dark Ninja Day Porcelain Power Pirates treasure map, but I have since learned that it was just as counterfeit as the Power Pirate it led me to.
And who was the dastardly swindler who sold you this map?
It was...
Hey, would you look at that? I've misfiled my glorious mundus. Your Honor, on behalf of the Porcelain Power Pirates Corporation, I'd like to ask that all charges pertaining to the unfortunate counterfeiting of the Dark Ninja Dave action figure be dropped against Captains Joaquin D'Oro and Guybrush Threepwood.
Smart move, Counselor! In the matter of Porcelain Power Pirates versus D'Oro, D'Oro versus Threepwood, etc., 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 this court finds in favor of the defendants!
All this justice? Where's the hangings?
You want hangings? Just keep it up, you swabs!
I'd like to call Hemlock McGee to the stand.
Hemlock McGee!
What's that?
Oh.
And do you swear on Blackbeard?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Listen, Pinky. I knew Blackbeard back when he was bloody Black Peach Fuzz. Just let me at him. Let me at him!
Ensign McGee, it's your contention that Captain Threepwood injured your cat.
Injured? He practically crushed him. Hit him right in the puss with a stuffed manatee, as he did.
And how is your cat today?
See for yourself. The poor dear is paralyzed with fear. I have to feed her through a tube. Oh, my poor Miss Pretty Whiskers. Oh, my poor little Pretty
Whiskers. Pretty Whiskers?
Your witness, kid.
Your Honor, I'd like to call a recess to confer with my client.
Bailiff! Please escort Captain Threepwood to the brig!
Aye, aye, Your Honor!
Hey, guard!
What do you want?
I want to see my lawyer.
Again?
Not getting any smarter.
Stand
understand?
Kybrush Threepwood. Nice to see you out and about, kid. Hope they haven't been treating you too badly in the Hooskow.
Well, there is a pretty scary-looking rat in my cell. At least I hope it's a rat.
Well, that's just swell, kid. Look, could you get out of the way and make room for some paying customers?
I know I'll kick myself for asking, but what sorts of trial souvenirs are you selling?
The question you should be asking is what kind of souvenirs am I not selling? Behold, the People vs. Threepwood collection!
What's that?
That, my piratey friend, is a little novelty I like to call Draw the Beard on the Guybrush. Using the power of magnetism and iron shavings, you can give Flotsam's most notorious criminal an infinite array of amusing and degrading hairstyles. Observe. What the? This one doesn't have a magnet. And look, it's leaking iron shavings. This is what you get when you use shoddy Fat Island labor.
On second thought.
Say no more.
See you in court, Stan.
Hey, that's pretty funny.
Hey, look! A five-headed bonobo!
What? I didn't see nothing!
Sorry. Must have been a weather balloon.
Who go?
Oh, it's you.
To return to court to defend my client.
Alrighty then, let's find Judge Grindstump.
The Pirate Court of Flotsam Island is...
Yes, yes, get on with it!
I'd like to call Hemlock McGee back to the stand.
I'm right here!
I'd like to remind...
Hey, I'm still under oath.
Your Honor, pirates and assorted buccaneers, Hemlock McGee has asserted that it was I, Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate, that brought about the horrible emotional scars that even now leave poor Miss Pretty Whiskers paralyzed with fear. But I put it to you that it was not your humble defendant who traumatized Hemlock's unfortunate feline, but a far more insidious assailant, one who's in this very courtroom as I speak. J'accuse! Jacques the Monkey!
What?
Objection! There's no evidence of monkey play here.
No? Let's ask the victim.
Miss Pretty Whiskers!
I see. Miss Pretty Whiskers is up and about and seeking revenge just like a good pirate cat should.
Miss Pretty Whiskers, come back! We'll get our revenge together.
Your Honor, I rest my case.
Mr. Prosecutor!
Well, considering that my client and evidence just ran out the door, I guess old Stan's gonna have to drop this one.
Good idea! In the case of McGee and Pretty Whiskers versus Threepwood, the Pirate Court of Flotsam finds in favor of the defendant, Guybrush Threepwood!
Come on, Judge, get him with the pox!
Don't make me send the bailiff up there! Let's see here. Cleared? Dropped? Yes! Congratulations, Captain Threepwood! It appears that you have successfully gotten yourself out from under your various civil charges.
Shivery timbers, Stumpy. I guess I'll be going now.
Hold on, what's this? There appears to be a criminal charge on the other side of this blasted paper.
Huh? Assault with molten nacho cheese isn't criminal? What else is there?
The creation, incubation, dissemination, proliferation, and mastication of a pox or pox-like affliction. A class one felonious act here on Flotsam.
Oh, pox!
How do you plead?
Not guilty.
On what grounds?
The pox isn't my fault. It's LeChuck's. It all started with the cursed Cutlass of Khaflu. Off the Rock of Gelato, LeChuck was doing something evil with monkeys, and I was all brrr. But then LeChuck broke my root beer bottle, and I had to substitute some of the Voodoo Lady's ingredients, and then LeChuck turned into a human, and all this voodoo went boom, and... well, it's not my fault.
Your Honor, the defendant is hand-waving. And believe me, I know from hand-waving. But seriously, we all know that the cloud of pox vexing this fair island arrived soon after the defendant and his oozing appendage crept upon these shores.
Disgust-appraising it was.
Then, after infecting everyone in sight, the pox cloud magically blew away at exactly the same moment that Guybrush sailed away, stealing Flotsam's only ship, I might add.
I won that ship, fair and square.
Now, Threepwood has returned, and so has the cloud of pox. What a coincidence. And yet here he stands concocting fanciful stories of a human LeChuck, voodoo cutlasses, and a so-called Rock of Gelato.
Well, Threepwood, do you have any witnesses to your unlikely tale?
I do. She's... Wonder Bunny.
Basky blubbering belugas! I'm sucking your port! Bring me all your spoiled swags, booty and boodle!
Lane, let's plunder more bunny, please.
And you, me bunny lass, step into me captain's quarters and let me ravish you.
Oh, boy.
Ah, to finally hold you in me arms again, it makes me want to... What's this? The scent of betrayal? Who is this tawdry witch?
Nobody. No one.
She'll die by me rusty blade!
There's my witness.
And she must be summoned! Bailiff, serve the woman immediately!
Yes, sir.
You'd better be using the voodoo summons. That saucy sea hag doesn't look like she be respecting the customs of pirate law.
Aye, aye, sir.
But first, hold the defendant's pox-spreading keister back to the brig!
All right, you! Stay put until I summon your ball and chain.
I wouldn't call her that. She...
Ow!
Mike?
Oof!
Take exception. What happened to you?
Oh, I'll tell you what happened. I went to Club 41 to hand this summons to your better half, and she backhanded me right out of the bar! Oh!
Ouch.
If you want that banshee on the stand, you're gonna have to serve her yourself. Go see if the local doctor can fix me jawbone.
What the? Oh, ladies' night.
Guybrush, your wife has lost her mind.
And you're about to lose a limb, you sea cow.
Elaine, sugar cakes, let's stop fighting and work this out over a nice cold light grog.
It's her head or yours, bilge boy.
Or you two can just figure out this little misunderstanding on your own. I'll be over here appreciating my head's ability to stay attached to my neck. My recipe for something called a Fat Island Fuzzy Nostril. Hey, Krebs.
What do you want?
Tell me, did it hurt?
Did what hurt?
When you fell out of pirate heaven?
No, but this will.
Stay away from Guybrush, you sea hog!
Just what I always wanted. An ant-infested sack of sugar. Can you make one of these Fat Island fuzzy nostrils?
Aye, aye, Captain!
And while you're making that, I'll just...
Order up! One Fat Island fuzzy nostril, heavy on the fuzz.
That was absurdly fast.
Arr! Libations!
Ah, gimme!
Ew, what was that?
Hey, what's this piece of paper stuff? It's a recipe for a drink called a Tri-Island Tuna Colada. Looks complicated. Hey, Krebs!
What do you want?
What you gonna do with all that gold?
All what gold?
All that gold inside your chest.
Stay away from Guybrush, you sea hog!
Can you make one of these?
A Tri-Island Tuna Colada? Arr, that takes me back. I haven't made one of these since I was a bosun under Captain Bo.
But can you make one? I'm really in the mood.
Aye, but it'll take some doing to scrounge up the ingredients.
Take your time. I'll just put this here for safekeeping.
Done! One Tri-Island Tuna Colada. Now I can get back to me darts.
Arr! Libations!
Ah, gimme!
Morgan, what do you think you're doing?
Don't ask me! Ask your crazy wife!
I'm gonna run you through, you high seas hussy!
Elaine, Tuckle Bear, Morgan's all bark and no bite.
You want bite? Ugh, you got it! And I'll throw in the bark for free!
Good for nothing words getting in the way of my killing.
Honey, you are formally summoned to appear before the court of Judge Grindstump in the case of the people of Flotsam versus Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate. TM.
Phew! Now I know who wears the daddy pants in the relationship.
You stay away from my boy's pants, or I'll hang you from my Jolly Roger, you Jezebel! And you, don't think you can totter around with some tart and not get a fistful of what?
She's a catch.
And conveniently not a rotten double-crosser.
I told you I had a job to do.
Sure, just doing your job. Tell me. Aside from all the silver, how are the benefits?
Guybrush.
Do you get health care for the repetitive stress injuries caused by all the backstabbing and cutting off people's hands?
I said I was sorry.
Sorry? I can't pick my left nostril without risking a lobotomy.
What if I...
What if nothing? Goodbye, Morgan. I've got a wife to cure and an island to save. Mrs. Threepwood. I'd like a second to think about my next move, Your Honor.
Make it fast! Your character witness is oozing all over my courtroom!
Your Honor, Buccaneers of Flotsam, you all believe that I, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate, have brought this horrible pox to your shores.
Off with his head!
Run him off the plank!
Into the jungle beast!
What if I were to tell you that I could tame this unruly witness, prove my good intentions, and begin the process of curing you all of this hideous voodoo pox all in one fell swoop?
Isn't so bad.
I don't know.
Maybe? To the jungle beast!
Your Honor, I object. Defense is grasping at sponge-shaped straws here.
Denied! But get on with it, Captain! The hangman gets overtime if we keep him up after midnight!
With pleasure, Your Honor. Wenches and pirates, I give you Exhibit S, the wonder of La Esponja Grande.
I thought it'd be bigger.
Now behold, as a simple exfoliating motion of La Esponja Grande washes away the pox, restoring my wife to her usual, mostly pleasant demeanor. Sugar cakes?
Off with his head!
Get that piece of seaweed off me, you deep-sea doily diver!
Does the defense have any other pointless arguments it would like to make?
This is sort of all I got.
Then, by the power vested in me by the put-upon pirates of Flotsam Island, I summarily sentence you to be hanged by your pox-spreading neck until you are
right there.
What?
Woof.
What is the meaning of this?
My name is LeChuck, and I can tell you exactly what Guybrush did.
LeChuck? I thought he was a ghost.
I heard he was a zombie.
Don't listen to him!
You see, Your Honor, the pox is all my fault.
Listen to him!
For decades, I dabbled in the dark forces of voodoo, clamoring for power. I hungered for it. I yearned for it. I pillaged, plundered, and killed for it!
I can attest to all of this.
And it was my accumulated voodoo that infected you all. Dark, evil voodoo that was explosively released when I was once again defeated by the perpetually heroic Guybrush Threepwood.
He's not kidding. I've killed him, like, 5 times.
So you see, Guybrush Threepwood is not the source of this pox. I am. And I hereby throw myself upon the mercy of this court, or lack thereof.
Off with your head!
But wait, there's more. It turns out I had an unknown, silent power urging me down those darkened voodoo corridors. A power far more insidious than I could ever hope to be. I submit to the court this journal, property of... the...
Quiet up there!
The voodoo lady!
Ooh, that creepy lady who lives in the shack?
What the what?
In these pages, you will find detailed plans laid out by the voodoo lady over the course of many years to manipulate my never-ending rise to power. My hunger for voodoo, my seemingly endless cycle of ironically comical death and disturbing resurrection. My obsession with the darling Elaine. It's all because of her.
Off with her head!
Feed him to the jungle beast!
It can't be true, can it?
Order! Order! I hereby call for the release of Guybrush Threepwood and the immediate imprisonment of LeChuck and the Voodoo Lady! To the brig with both of them!
I bet it up to me I catch with all this land-loving lollygagging! I'll plunder me some treasure!
Don't worry about me, my friend. Go cure your wife!
Well, I'm finally free, but now my pox-crazed wife is nowhere to be found. A mad scientist is hunting her for who knows what reason, and the legendary voodoo sponge that was supposed to cure her has turned out to be useless. Under normal circumstances, I'd ask the voodoo lady for help, but she's sitting in the jail cell next to my archenemy, who may or may not be my best friend, after it's been revealed that she has been the secret power behind most of my travails over most of my life as a pirate. Maybe I should have been a beekeeper like my Uncle Sid. Hey, you!
Hello, Threepwood.
You sent me on a wild albatross chase for La Esponja Grande and promised me it would cure the pox. But after fending off sexually ambiguous merpeople, a giant manatee, and your crazy ex-boyfriend, what do I get for my trouble? This sorry excuse for a kitchen sponge.
La Esponja.
Ah, I notice you strategically left out the Grande from this worthless piece of junk. Once it cured my piddly leftover pox, it didn't have enough mojo left to cure Elaine.
It's not worthless. It is merely young. It must be brought to maturity in order to reach its voodoo-absorbing potential.
Brought to maturity? How am I supposed to do that? Give it a talk about the sponge birds and sponge bees?
Like all infants, La Esponja needs nourishment. It must be fed 6 special voodoo courses to bring it to adult size.
What sort of meal is that?
A feast for the senses. The menu, Threepwood. Take it, and serve the sponge a meal unlike any other.
And then?
It will grow.
Hey, neat! There's a map of the Flotsam Jungle on the cover. No more listening to bees and birds and boars for this mighty pirate. Well, that's odd. It's like a whole new map now. What was that? Huh. Something sure shoved a short sword up his aft sail. What in the name of Bluebeard's hair dye?
Hey, no poaching! I have called dibs!
I think I may be lost. Shouldn't there be a creepy voodoo shack right about there?
There was, until they came to arrest that pox-spreading voodoo lady.
What happened?
First came the flames. Poor Senor Nipperkin went up like St. Elmo's fire. Then she emerged from the conflagration, mumbling ancient curses with every regal step. I never forget the baleful stare she fixed me with as she was left away. A look condemning me to a lifetime of suffering, shame, and regret.
Spooky.
And if that wasn't bad enough, I haven't found one bit of cool voodoo stuff in the wreckage. Come on!
Mob justice can be so unfair. Uh-oh. Looks like these finicky moths won't eat a jacket that's encrusted with bacon grease, fish water, and manatee guts. Lucky me. Alright, little fellas, check out these high-def duds. Well, that's just great. The lamp's dead. Well, at least Stan's sign is keeping the moths from returning to the jungle. Stan!
Threepwood! No hard feelings over all those various civil and criminal charges?
Water under the bridge.
Great!
A bridge with a fast-talking shyster-slash-salesman dangling from it. What kind of souvenirs could you possibly be making out of the Voodoo Lady and LeChuck?
Oh, ye of little faith! Feast your eyes on the all-new People vs. LeChuck and the Voodoo Lady collection!
What's that one?
That's our Cursed Cutlass of Kaflu LeChuck doll. Press the button for its special transforming glow.
What's happening?
It's a little bright.
Yeah, we're still working out a few kinks. Hey now, what's this? A fuzzy flying fan club? Ah! Hey, knock it off, you nutty nibblers! That hurts! Sweet, fancy! Ah! Moses! Ow! 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 Ouch! Well, that was one heck of an experience, eh, Threepwood? It's a good thing old Stan always keeps a few spare jackets in the back office, or I'd be defending my clients in the altogether. Say, that's not a bad idea. Stan S. Stanman, naked attorney at law. You've got nothing to hide, and neither does he. No time to chat, Threepwood. I've got business cards to print.
Sweet. You know, when I dreamed of becoming a mighty pirate, I never imagined that one day I'd be tying eye-popping napkins around the non-existent necks of mystical sponges. What's that artistic abomination?
Be a painting of Flotsam Island's notorious jungle beast, painted by our own Hemlock McGee.
Hemlock? Really?
Aye! No one knows more about our legendary beastie than old Hemlock.
Ouch!
Morgan! What happened?
Went to get your hand.
You didn't have to do that.
Had to pay you back for all the trouble. Found Jacques. He told me.
What?
He told me.
What? What did the monkey tell you? Singe.
Nemperidae flotsimus sucrosus, the flotsam jungle firefly, are a common sight in Flotsam's jungles, which they never leave. Although possessing no natural enemies, the flotsimus sucrosus has a notorious sweet tooth, drawing it inexorably to bodies of sugar water.
Oh no! This is where the Marquis keeps all the severed limbs of the pirates he's operated on. Hey, you never know when a sack of severed legs is gonna come in handy. Or footy, as the case may be. Sorry.
There, Double Peg. I hear you may know something about Flotsam's so-called jungle beast.
None have seen the jungle beast, but 'tis the scariest, foulest, smellinest thing you ever didn't see. A dark jungle god that walks the land only by dead of night.
Dark jungle god?
Aye. 'Twas said to live within the stomach of the god of death, feasting upon corpses, until one day death ate some bad shellfish and upchucked the jungle beast into existence.
But if you haven't seen it, how do you know it exists?
Because it eats. To appease the beast, they've left many a fleshy sacrifice on the jungle altar. By morning, the meat disappears from the altar without a trace.
Disappearing meat. Yep, jungle god's the only explanation. See ya.
To a briny pulp with him! What are you looking at?
This equal to eternal life.
Le spectre de Grand César!
Doesn't look like Elaine's in any immediate danger. Hopefully she won't commit any unforgivable atrocities before I finish enlarging my pox-curing sponge. Jungle fireflies, nature's little spotlights. The fireflies are attracted to the sugar water on the leg. Fascinating. And just a little nauseating. I don't know about mythical jungle beasts, but I always prefer my ritual sacrifices to be slathered in sugar water. Uh-oh.
I've lost that she-devil.
Ouch, that's gotta hurt. Serves him right, though. Still, I'd better finish feeding the sponge before Elaine hurts someone I actually care about. The mighty pirate hunter tracks his prey via his distinctive firefly-attracting spool. That's the legendary jungle beast of Flotsam Island? Here, boy. Ooh, that looks uncomfortable. But at least he's not snapping at me anymore. Don't worry, you freakish little abomination. Dr. Guybrush will make it all better. Gotcha! Phew! That is my far the foulest thing I've ever smelled in all my years of pirating. And that's coming from a guy who's just spent a few days inside a giant manatee. Come on, little sponge. Eat the nice smelly antipasta. That's a good sponge. Are you pirate enough to take the Fugu Jolokia challenge? Hey, WP!
Captain Threepwood! What can I do you for?
Tell me about this Fugu Jolokia challenge.
Ah! A connoisseur of peculiar culinary delights, are we?
Yes?
Then you surely have heard of the Fugu Jolokia, the hottest pepper in this world or the next.
Oh, that Fugu Jolokia.
I acquired that specimen of the Fugu pepper many years ago from a three-legged bandit named Ort, winning it from him when I was able to place me tongue on the pepper for 10 entire seconds.
How eccentric.
Since that tongue-destroying day, I've vowed to pass on the pepper to the first pirate who can successfully put his tongue on the Fugu Jolokia for 11 seconds.
What happened to Morgan's body? Auto trepanation helmet.
Ow! What? My thumb!
Bust my balustrades! Well done, Captain Threepwood! You've conquered the Fugu Jolokia and have won the right to keep it as your own!
I love a clean living and a healthy co-
Probably got permanent glossal damage, but it was totally worth it to get my hook on that pepper. Good thing the sponge doesn't have a tongue, or I'd be dunking it in the ocean right about now.
Ouch!
Let's see, what do I have now that I didn't have the last time I tried to open this chest?
Ow!
Stupid hook! Oh, it can't be that easy. The Voodoo Lady's tarot cards? That's it? I bent the fabric of reality for a stupid fortune teller's trick?
Okay, that's a pretty good trick. Hopefully these flakes of the future will give La Esponja a sixth sense that'll help keep me from getting into situations like this.
Tingly. Well, hey, what's this? Ah, so that was the shocking dessert. Ouch! Alright, Senor Esponja Not So Grande, that's 5 senses down and 1 to go. Now, where can I find a really big sound for an after-dinner belch? Well, there's only one thing on Flotsam Island that can make a noise like that.
Alouette, I live forever, Alouette, immortalité. Who will live forever, moi? Who will reconnaître moi? Alouette, I live forever, Alouette, immortalité.
Come on, you snuff-sniffing land licker!
You heard the lady, Desinge.
Guybrush, get out of here and find your own treasure. This one's mine.
Ah, the happy Threepwood Pirate Clan. Whatever shall I do now? Oh, I know.
Oh, clam dip.
Ha! I can't believe I ever married a dullard like you.
You know, once I cure you of the pox that's making you say all these mean things, you're gonna owe me a lot of smoochies.
I wouldn't smooch you with his lips, cabin boy.
I hate to break up this portrait of domestic bliss, but I've got some last-minute adjustments to make to my machinery before preparing the charming Madame Threepwood for her journey into scientific history.
Don't worry, Buttercup. Once I get La Esponja Grande into that noisy doohickey, our troubles will be over.
Yes. Well, please try to keep it down, no?
At least I hope so.
What's this? An airborne periphera?
Hey, give that back!
And risk tainting my moment of triumph with your tedious voodoo falderal. I don't think so.
Moment of triumph?
Oui. Using my Arpsichronoton, I have discovered the unique harmonic frequency that allows me to pulverize matter into a fine powder and spread it across the seas. Observe!
Arrgh! It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate. It's me! First of all, thanks. That thing was really starting to scrape my scab. Second, you're crazy if you think you're gonna get me in there. Okay, crazier.
You? I don't want you. It's your wife's molecules I need to smear across the seas.
I'd like to see you try, you wuss.
Why her?
Because of her pox, you dolt. She's got the same unique strain of the pox that you once had. The same one that was flowing through your amazing hand. The same one that I've distilled into my amazing jus de vie.
Wufty.
Unfortunately, a single hand can only provide enough of the Threepwood strain to produce a few meager drams of my jus de vie. Even if I were to drain your beloved to the bone, I would only gain a few piddling firkins of the juice.
Give you some piddling firkins?
No. If I want a perpetual strain of the jus de vie, every pirate in the world must be exposed to the Threepwood strain. Now, Madame Threepwood, if you'll understand for a moment, I'll try to make this as painless as possible.
How nice. But I won't. Oh.
Behold the power of this jus de vie.
Oh, what the heck. Sweet.
Oh, shiny.
Hey, Boo!
What now? What in the world? Oh, shoot!
Hey, the monkey!
What?
You'll never get past my wife's sword, you know. I once saw her hold off a horde of angry Rotarians with nothing more than a penknife and a feather duster.
Impressive. But unless they were invulnerable Rotarians fueled by my incredible jus de vie, there's really no comparison. Soon she will tire, and her pox will be mine to spread across the four corners of the earth.
I'll spring you to the four corners!
What now?
My cabin!
No! Shoot! Oh, get away from me, you nasty little pest! No!
What's the matter with him?
Without my hand to supply him with more jus de vie, all those wounds you've been inflicting are starting to catch up with him.
Get back here, you naughty little hand! I have you now, my pretty.
Nice one, Hand. Care to help me with these locks? I guess that was a little too much to ask. At least I've got the sponge back, though. Was a little antic from that.
Whoa!
Now that's an esponja grande! But how will I use it to cure... Oh, right! The wind!
And why does my mouth taste like coleslaw?
It's a long story. I'll tell you all about it once we figure out how to get out of these stupid clamshells.
Leave everything to me, my friends.
LeChuck, my new best pal. How'd you get out of jail?
Oh, the guard was more than happy to release me once I convinced him that it was the only way to win Elaine's hand in unholy matrimony.
Wait, unholy what?
Unholy this!
Guybrush!
Elaine?
Guybrush!
LeChuck! This name shouting is jolly good fun!
Is that you, Mother? I washed my hands.
I knew it all along. With or without all that voodoo, you're still nothing but an evil sack of scum!
Correction, my sweet. I'm an evil sack of scum who's about to plunder the grandest treasure in all creation. But I'd be willing to share my booty if you catch me drift.
What?
Oh, come now, my love. You can't deny what we've shared these past few weeks. The chummy camaraderie, the kind words, the stolen glances. I know you've developed feelings for me. Join me as my demon bride, and together we'll lay a bloody siege to the very heart of voodoo itself!
Go to hell, LeChuck.
Well, you can't say I didn't try. Looks like we'll be doing this with all that voodoo.
Elaine? Do me a favor.
Ah! That be the stuff!
Anything.
Kick his two-faced butt for me.
From Melee to Monkey and all the islands in between, my love.
Aren't you dead yet? I've got wedding plans to make.
Out of respect for the newly deceased, I feel I should point out that you wave your sword like a dairy farmer.
How appropriate. You fight like a pox-infected undead cow.
Ha 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 ha!
Mm-hmm.